Random House Audio presents Reb Kringle, a short story from For the Relief of Unbearable Urges by Nathan Englander, read for you by Arthur Morey. Buna Mikla stuck her head into the men's section of the sanctuary, hesitant, even though her husband was the only man there. "Itzy," she said. He was over by the ark, changing the bulb in the eternal light, pretending that he hadn't heard. "Itzy, the children. Think of all the children."
"Bah."
He screwed in the bulb with his handkerchief, and the eternal light flickered once before resuming its usual glow. Reb Yitzchak folded his hanky carefully, and slipping a hand under his kaftan, stuffed it into his back pocket.
"Itzy."
He turned to face her. "I should worry over the children? These are my children, all of them, that I should worry over them and their greed?" She walked to the heart of the sanctuary and sat in the front row of the easterly facing benches. "You should worry, maybe, over your shul. You should worry over the mortgage that is due." Buna took a deep breath. It was satisfying to yell at this stubborn man. "How many people pray here, Yitzhala? How many prayers go up to heaven from under this roof?" "There are 31 people who pray here 3 times a day, and I don't know how many prayers reach heaven. If I knew such things, I would also know a better way to pay the rent." "And what of the roof under which we sleep?" "Yes, Buna, and I would know also how to pay for the roof." "How to pay, you already know," she said. "4 weeks' work is food in our mouths, so what's the question? For 11 months you won't be forced to smile." Reb Yitzchak considered his wife's statement. Every year it was the same argument, and every year he lost. If only he had been born a wiser man, or married a simpler woman. He put his fingers into his long white beard and slowly worked them down toward its jagged end. "It's a sin, this job," was all he came up with.
"It is absolutely not a sin. Where does it say that playing with Goyish children is a sin? There is no rule against playing games with them."
"Playing? You haven't seen, Buna. Anyone who has seen would never call such mayhem playing. Not since the time of Noah has the world seen such boundless greed."
"So it's not playing, fine, but you're going, and you will be jolly and laugh like the bride's father at a wedding, miserable or not."
Reb Yitzchak took off his kaftan and made his way down to the basement, leaning against the banister with every step. He was a heavy man, big in the belly, and his sciatica was acting up. The rickety wood stairs groaned as he headed down into the darkness, where he grabbed at the air in search of the frayed string and the lone 60-watt bulb. The oil burner sat under a web of rusted pipes that spread across the low ceiling. Behind the burner, there was a turn in the basement leading to a narrow dead end of storage space. It was the farthest place from anything. The best place to keep the Passover dishes so that they shouldn't be contaminated during the rest of the year. He pulled the sheets off the boxes, all of which were marked Pesach in Hebrew, with a big black marker. He couldn't make out the words since the light from the bulb barely reached that part of the room, but Reb Yitzchak didn't need to see so well. What he was looking for was recognizable by feel. The box he needed was fancy. Not like the kind one brings home from the alley behind the supermarket, the sides advertising cereals and toilet paper, boxes living already a second life. This one had a top to it, the kind that could be lifted off, like a hat box, but square. This box felt smooth to the touch, overlaid with satin. When his fingers brushed against it, he knew. As he picked up the box, Reb Yitzchak employed the backsaver erect spine lift, counting out the positions.
1. Feet apart. 2. Bend knees.
Exactly as Dr. Middleman had shown him. Trudging up the stairs and directly to the front door, Itzik stopped and pushed the cumbersome pack.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.